In this video, we're going to compare the Noctua NH-L9x65 to the Noctua NH-D12L CPU coolers using machine learning on over 1 million data points. The information in this video can also be found on my website at pcanalytics.com, and the product links can be found in the description below. With that in mind, let's start by looking at some qualitative metrics. The NH-D12L CPU cooler image shows the side of the cooler that would face the RAM, while the L9x65 lays flat on the motherboard. With that in mind, neither cooler will have RAM clearance issues in most setups. Additionally, each cooler uses a single fan, with the L9x65 using a 92mm fan and the D12L using a 120mm fan. It is possible to add additional fans on the D12L cooler. However, the L9x65 is limited to a single 92mm fan. In regards to installation, both coolers are relatively easy to install. Next, let's dig into the performance. We're going to cover two sets of graphs, one normalized by percent speeds and the second normalized by noise levels. Note that these graphs are created by using machine learning models to help break down the performance using over 1 million data points in an open case. This means that performance may differ depending on your case's airflow and your CPU. To orient you to the graph, the left side shows temperatures corresponding to the solid lines, with the right side showing noise levels represented by the dashed lines. As a general rule, lower is always better for the data shown. With that in mind, we will first look at the fan's performance on an idle CPU, which is assumed to be using 30 watts of power. When comparing the L9x65 cooler in red to the D12L cooler in blue, the D12L runs a few degrees cooler across the board at significantly lower noise levels. As we increase the watts to 105, which is what the CPU is rated for, we can see that the L9x65 struggles to maintain desirable temperatures, while the D12L handles the higher temperature well. Next, we will look at the CPU overclocked to 125 watts. This shows that the D12L handles overclocked temperatures well, while the L9x65 is unable to handle the load and will throttle performance. Next, for the second set of comparisons, we will look at the performance for a given noise level. The graph shown has noise on the bottom axis, while keeping the temperatures on the side axis. Note that lower is still better for this graph. When comparing the coolers by normalized noise levels, we see that the NH-D12L performs much better for a given noise level. As we increase the watts to 105, we see the gap widens materially. And as we increase the wattage to 125, we can see that this trend continues. Overall, while the L9x65 cooler is a good cooler while you have limited space, it doesn't hold well against a normal tower cooler. For this reason, the D12L is a winner for this comparison. If you enjoyed this video, you should check out this one. Thank you for watching.